It is said that information is king, but information not only needs to be transmitted, but also replicated. And that's certainly important for what happens in the cell with respect to its nucleic acid information. In this lecture, I'm going to cover the replication of DNA and the repair of DNA. So DNA replication is a process that is essential for the transmission of genetic information. The structure of DNA discovered in 1953 gave clues to how it would be replicated. First of all, this DNA molecule is complementary. The bases on one strand form complements to bases on the other strand. There's a phosphodiester backbone that holds the individual bases together on one strand, as we can see. And the bases project into the middle of what is the double helix. Now, the base pairing occurring in the center is stabilized by hydrogen bonds, as we will see. So, as we will see, there are some significant differences between the systems of replication that involved in prokaryotic versus eukaryotic cells because of the nature of the genetic information in the two. But the overall DNA replication process itself, mechanistically, is not significantly different. Now, when we think about DNA replication, at the very beginning of DNA replication, it starts at a specific sequence. We've seen in another lecture how a transcription of RNA begins at a promoter. In DNA replication, the replication process begins at a sequence called an origin. Proteins bind to the origin to help the replication process to occur, very much like what we saw in transcription, except for here, the idea is the replication of DNA. They will open the double helix to allow the access of the replication proteins to get in and begin. The replication requires a reader of the template and a catalytic function to make phosphodiester bonds. Basically, what I'm talking about here is a DNA polymerase. It reads one strand, grabs the appropriate base, and then incorporates that into the strand that it's building. Now, there are several proteins involved in the replication of DNA, and I'd like to just first list them, and then we'll see individually what they do later. First, there's a DNA polymerase that's involved, as I said, in actually making the phosphodiester bonds to join everything. There's a primase that's a protein that actually helps to start the synthesis of the DNA. There's something called the single-stranded binding protein, which, as its name suggests, binds to single strands. Enzymes called helicases help the process to advance, as we shall see, at an incredible rate. An enzyme called topoisomerase helps with traffic jams that happen during the replication process. And these traffic jams literally can be knots in the DNA if they're not taken care of. A primer remover is necessary because the primer is where the replication process gets started. And as we'll see, that primer's start is not DNA. And last in the process, we have to have something called DNA ligase, because this is how all the individual pieces of the DNA during replication get joined together.